In this video, we are going to configure add to cart event for Shopify store using Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics 4 properties. Let's head over to my computer so we can start by configuring Google Analytics 4 property in Google Tag Manager so we can track basic events. You can head over to analytics.google.com and then go to the bottom left corner where you can find the option for admin. Under the property column, you can find the option for data streams. Data streams are just like pipelines which will help your website to connect with Google Analytics 4. If you already have a web stream, that's well and good. If you don't have it, you can create an ad stream and create a web property. We already have a web stream, so what we are going to do is just copy the measurement ID. We are going to use this measurement ID again and again, so we will create a constant variable for this in Google Tag Manager. Let's head over to tagmanager.google.com and go to the variable section so we can create a constant variable where we can refer to this measurement ID later on. We can name this as GA4 measurement ID and let's hit save. Now we have created a user defined Google Analytics 4 property measurement ID, which we can use later in the video. Now let's head over to the tag section and we are going to create one tag that will fire on all the pages of the website. Let's hit new on the top right corner. And for the trigger, we want this event to fire on all the pages of the website. Under the tag configuration, we are going to use Google Tag. Google Tags are a new way of configuring events and this has replaced the previous Google Analytics 4 configuration tag. If you have an older Google Tag Manager container, you might be looking at the GA4 configuration tag. Under the Google ID field, we are going to refer back to the GA4 property that we created. And let's rename this tag GTag GA4 configuration tag. This naming convention is not necessary. You can name it however you want. I just like the way how I name things. Now we have created a Google Analytics 4 configuration tag. Let's hit preview to connect this with our website and check if the Google Analytics 4 configuration tag is firing on the website or not. Let's hit connect. Now our website has been connected with the debug view of Google Tag Manager. And if you have this Chrome extension, you can see that we have one Google Tag Manager container firing on the website and we do have a global site tag firing. Let's head back to the debug view and we can see that the configuration tag has fired. On the top, you can see we have two different containers. One is for Google Tag Manager and one is for the GA4 property. Once you hit on GA4, you can see that it has sent one page view on this particular page. On the left side of the summary, these tabs are for the pages. If you refresh the page again, it will fire one more page. And you can see this page has also sent one page view event. All the page view events are sent on the configuration event. So therefore, we call this as a configuration tag. Now we have successfully configured the configuration tag. Now the next thing is to configure add to cart event based on the button click. This is not an ideal way to configure it. However, if you don't have a developer available and you're not very good with the programming skills, then this is next to the best thing that you can do for yourself. Let's head over to any of the product pages to see what kind of information we have and what kind of button we need to track. Let's head over to any of the products. We can see that we have a button called add to cart. Once I will click on this button, there should ideally be an event that has fired here, which is called click. And we can see that in the Google Tag Manager container, that event has not triggered. This is because we don't have an active trigger that is looking for a click event. So let's head over to the triggers and create a new trigger for button click events. For right now, we are not going to make it specific. We are just going to create one button for anything. Let's name it all element. Hit preview on the Google Tag Manager web container so the debug window will open with the new trigger added to the preview mode. Let's head back to any of the product pages again and click on add to cart button to see what kind of information we have. Here you can see an event number 13 has triggered, and if you open this API call, you can see that there might be some additional information that has been populated. If you go to the variable section, you see that you don't have any other information such as click ID, click text and things like that. That is because you have not enabled these variables right now. So if you head back to the Google Tag Manager web container and go to the variable section, on the first top corner, you can see the built-in variables. We are going to enable some of the built-in variables that are related to the button elements, such as button element, classes, target, URLs, and text. We are most likely going to be use click text thing. So let's just hit preview to see if we get any other additional information in these variables that we can use in the trigger. Let's head back to the website, any of the product pages to see what information we have. Let's click on add to cart again. Go back to the debug view, click on the click event go to the variables, and we can see that the click text has the text add to cart. We can use this add to cart variable to differentiate the button click element from all the events. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager and open the trigger that we just created a few minutes ago, which is for all elements button click. So instead of this button to fire on all the clicks, we want it to fire on some specific clicks, and those some specific clicks are going to be where the click text contains add to cart. Let's rename this button to a button click add to cart, so we know that this is the add to cart button click event. Let's head back to the Google Tag Manager and create a tag that will fire whenever this button has been triggered. Let's click on new. Under the triggering section, we are going to select the trigger we just created, and under the tags, we are going to look for a GA4 events tag. This is referring to the same measurement ID, therefore we created a variable so we can reuse it again and again. The standard event name for add to cart event is add to cart, with spaces replaced with underscore and everything lowercase. Once we have created this event, we can rename it as GA4 EEC add to car event. Let's hit save and do a test to make sure everything is working all right or not. Let's hit preview to connect the debug view with the website again. Let's scroll down to open any of the product and hit add to cart button. Ideally, what should have happened is that the add to cart event should have fired and this should have sent an event. We can either open the Google Analytics 4 container and click on the add to cart event, and we can see that it has sent an event back to the GA4. And on your GA4 property, if you have connected it with the debug view, you can click on the debug view to see that information coming into the GA4 account. We can see that the add to cart event has came in. There is one more place where you can see this information, that is under the real time view. If you will click on the home button on the left top corner, so you can see a card for real time. Once you will click on the real time reports, you can see all the events that are firing on the website, and we can see that one add to cart event has been triggered. In this third section of the video, we are going to see how you can track add to cart event with the enhanced e-commerce data, so you can track information such as item ID, name, value, quantity, etc. You need to have some sort of programming knowledge. If you don't, we also have a document attached in the link of this description where you can just refer this document to the developer and they can handle everything. Otherwise, you can also find another link for the code snippet that we're going to use in this video. Let's head back to Shopify stores and see how we are going to add the code snippet in the Shopify store. Once you are on the Shopify store, you will be on the homepage. Let's click on the online store so we can edit the theme. Make sure you are on the theme section. By default, it will always open the theme, but make sure you are here. On the current theme do you have, click on the three dots and click edit code. It is always advisable to duplicate the website code before making any changes, but we are just doing it on a dummy website, so we are not going to be extra sure for any extra steps. Let's hit edit code so we can go to the back end of the website and make any changes to the add to cart event. There are two different kinds of code snippet that can be used. One code snippet is added to the head section of the website and it hits trigger on all the pages, and the second kind of snippet is added directly on the product template page where the add to cart button exists. To keep everything clean, we are going to create snippets to make sure everything is consistent. Let's head back to the snippet section and create add snippet. Let's create a head data layer. This head data layer will be on all the pages of the website, and we can include this directly on the theme file. In this head data layer file, we are going to copy and paste the code that you can find from the link in the description. What this code is going to do, this will check if the customer has logged into the website. It will populate their customer data for enhanced user data thing for Google Ads. This is not much relevant for GA4. However, we are using the user ID field to track user ID if the user exists. The second file we need for this one is product data layer, and this one will only fire on the template pages. So let's create one more snippet with the same name, product data, and hit save. We also need to save the file for the head data layer. In this data layer product file, you are going to paste the code which you can find from the description below. What this code is going to do, this will trigger view item event as well as add to cart item event in the data layer that we can use for Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics 4. You might also see that we are not using the standard naming event as GA4, and we have added an extra prefix of custom underscore behind this event. This is an extra precautionary step because sometimes you might have some other integration or plugin that is using the exact same name, so we don't want these events to conflict with them. So we are referring them as custom underscore view item and custom underscore add to cart. All the event naming that we have used in the data layer, they all have this kind of naming structure. All right, let me walk you through this code so you can have somewhat understanding and you can modify this code if you needed to. We are picking up the default product that we have on this template file, and then we are creating an item object that will be used for view item event as well as add to cart item event. The view item event just fires as soon as the DOM loaded, and the add to cart event is a trigger that has been added to all the elements that has this name equals add inside the button click element. Let's hit save. We also need to do one more thing. In the theme file, we are going to add this head data layer file right above the Google Tag Manager web container. I have included the head data layer file, so this will now trigger right above the Google Tag Manager container code. If you have the Google Tag Manager container code somewhere else in the file, you can just paste this above or below that. Let's hit save and go back to the Google Tag Manager container and hit preview. Preview is not required per se because we haven't made any changes on the Google Tag Manager container, but this is just a habit of me doing it. Let's select any of the products and go to the product page to see if we have view item event and add to cart item events firing on the website. Now we are on the product page, and let's hit back to the debug view to see if the events are firing. We can see that the custom view item event has fired here, and this has the value of the event, currency, and all the other details. Now we are going to trigger the add to cart event for which this video has been created. Let's click on the button to trigger the event. Now you can see that the click event has also fired, but now there is an additional custom add to cart event in the data layer. And this add to cart event has all these details such as quantity, price, value, etc. Now we can use this data layer instead of the button click event to trigger this add to cart event. Let's head back to the Google Tag Manager web container and edit this existing tag that we have for Google Analytics 4 add to cart event. The first thing we are going to do is modify this trigger. We can modify this trigger directly by clicking here, or you can go back to the trigger section and from there. Let's click on the trigger, and the first thing we need to do is we don't need to use a button click event anymore. We need an event, custom event, and the name of the custom event we are going to use is custom add to cart, because this is something that is right now triggering on this debug view and we want to use the same name. So let's copy and paste this thing and rename this to custom event custom add to cart, and we don't need to fire it on the add to cart event because this does not trigger on the add to cart event. Let's hit save. Now this event will trigger add to cart, but this will not have any additional details such as currency, items, and all that thing. So we can add those details directly in this tag, or we can do one better thing. We can create a variable that will have all this information, and we can refer back to the same variable in all these other tags that we'll create for GA. Let's hit edit all the tag and go to event properties. Now we are going to create an event variable. This is very similar to how Universal Analytics has a settings variable. Let's create a new variable first because we don't have anything right now. Under this Google tag event settings variable, we need three things. The first thing we need is an items array. We also need currency, and we need value parameter. If a parameter is already registered in GA4, you will see this tick mark. If this event parameter is not available in GA4, then you will not see this. For example, this custom event parameter is not a standard event parameter, so you don't see a tick mark with it. We don't need this one, so we are going to remove it. In order for GA4 to know all these details such as item ID, item name, etc., we don't have to send this information separately. We can just refer back to the same e-commerce item object and everything will work fine. So let's head back to the data layer and see where this item exists. This item is under e-commerce and then items. So how we are going to reference is e-commerce dot items. Anything inside the curly braces can be referred using the dot notation. So let's head back to the Google Tag Manager container. Under the value next to the items, we will click plus, and we are going to create a new user defined variable for data layer. In this data layer, we are going to refer that e-commerce dot items variable. Let's rename this tag for e-commerce.item. So what this will do is that it will look for the e-commerce object, and then it will find the items array and send it back to the GA4. We need to do the same thing for currency, but let's head back to the data layer and check where the currency is. So under the e-commerce, we have to look for currency. So it should be e-commerce.currency. Let's create a new data layer variable and name it currency. Let's rename the tag to data layer variable e-commerce.current. And the last parameter we need is for the value. Let's head back to the debug view once more to see where the value is. It is under e-commerce.value. So let's head back to the Google Tag Manager to create a new user-defined variable for this value. We need e-commerce.value. If you're curious how I opened this one, this is using Window and V. You need to enable Keep Clipboard for this one, and I'm not really sure if this is a Mac OS feature or not. Let's hit save. Now you have these three event setting parameters that you can refer again and again. We are going to rename this as Google Tag Event Setting, and this is for e-commerce event parameters. Let's hit save, and now this event parameter will be sent whenever this event tag fires. Let's hit save and do one more preview to make sure everything is working all right or not. Let's go back to the website, click on any of the products that we might have here, and let's click on Add to Cart. This Add to Cart event has triggered, and now we can see that it has also fired the event. And in this GA4 event, we can see that the items array is being passed to the GA4. We can also verify the same thing using the GA4 container. In the GA4 container, you can see a standard event under the 17. It might be different depending on how many events are firing in your data layer. Once you hit an add to cart, you can scroll down to see we have one e-commerce item, and it has all the details such as ID, product name, currency, and all these other things. We can go back to the analytics to verify everything. We can see that we have some add to cart events firing, but among all of these events, only one of the events will have currency and value parameter. By default, in the preview mode, it does not show you the items array, but if you want to see what kind of items array are coming in, and since we have connected the debug view, we can go to the admin, and under the property column, we can click on debug view, and the debug view will show us the new add to cart event. And new add to cart event shows us that we have currency, value, and we have the items array, and you can expand the item array to see the item ID, quantity, and all these other things. Perfect. So this is one of the ways to track this event using the event snippet code directly inside the Shopify. And now we have successfully published the add to cart event using Google Analytics 4. If you want to see how we can configure the view item event, you can refer to this video for Shopify and GA4 account. And if you're looking to how to configure begin checkout event, that will be the next video, and you can also find that in the same playlist.